Hey little booze, welcome to Friday. This week has been actually insane. Although to be honest, when is it not insane in this country? True story, am I right? The last 3 days have been all about the scandal du jour. Although shouldn't it be de la semaine? Do I even speak French? I'm so sorry for my elementary school teacher. That was horrible. Whatever. Christina Kirchner is in trouble once again after some explosive news this week. Federal judge Claudio Bonadio ordered the detention of at least 15 people in relation to a massive corruption scheme that allegedly took place under all three of Kirchner administrations. The story is as weird as it gets and sounds like a crazy remake of that final scene from Cruel Intentions. Do you guys even remember Cruel Intentions? Sarah Michelle Gellar, Reese Witherspoon, Ryan Phillippe's butt? No? God, I'm such an old, they're not gonna get this. Anyway, thing is, this is a pretty big escándalo because it involves public officials who took bribes from business leaders so their companies could get public works contracts from the government, mainly in the energy and construction sectors. This guy you see here is Roberto Barata. Barata. He was the Secretary of Coordination and Administration at the Planning Ministry during the Kirchner administrations. Wow, that is a f***ing mouthful. Can we say f***? Probably not. Do we have to beep that out? Okay. He was also close to Planning Minister Julio De Vido, who, in case you forgot, is currently in prison awaiting trial for another corruption case. Still with me? Okay. As it turns out, this guy Barata had a personal driver named Oscar Centeno, who apparently kept secret records of his boss's activities. According to him, between the years 2008 and 2015, Barata was paid millions of dollars in bribes that he carried around in his car. Toyota Corolla, what up? And Centeno decided to secretly write down the names, location, and exact amounts of money involved every time that happened. Nice. Smart. The result was 8 notebooks filled with all that information, ending up in the hands of a group of journalists from La Nación, who in turn handed them over to federal prosecutor Carlos Tornelli before even breaking the story themselves. Nice work. Do you now get the Cruel Intentions reference? What do you guys even watch these days? Twilight? I don't know. Okay. But as I was saying, this could potentially reach former President Christina Kirchner, who has already been called into questioning since some of that money was allegedly stashed in her very posh apartment in Recoleta. Talking about being of the people, am I right? We've got some abortion news now, and I know, you have abortion news fatigue. It's a syndrome. I have it too. I also have giant, ridiculous papier-mâché fetus fatigue, but here I am covering this stuff for you, the people. Although I really shouldn't be complaining because I could be writing Twilight fanfiction for the youths. Fun fact time. Did you know that 50 Shades of Grey was originally a Twilight fanfiction story? I know you don't believe me, but I swear it's true. Go Google it right now. I'll wait. Now, whoever wrote that crap is rich, and I'm here being poor, so I guess the joke is on me, which is the story of my life. Okay, we are less than a week out from the big day when the Senate is scheduled to debate the abortion decriminalization bill, and it pains me to say that things are not looking good. On Wednesday, pro-choice senators failed to get enough votes to amend certain parts of the bill that was passed by the lower house in June. They were trying to make some changes before it hits the floor next week, hoping to convince senators on the fence, but fell short. So ultimately, the bill will be debated as is on August 8th. This is bad news, since there are already 35 senators out of 72 that oppose it. And in case of a tie, it's up to the vice president to decide, and she's way against it. Like, she is probably the most anti, so that will not go well. We'll see how it goes, but for now, all I want to do is cry, so just hold me until the pain goes away, please, someone. All right, in happier news, moving on to events. This Saturday, we have the Historias que Enamoran Festival at the Centro Cultural Borges. Acclaimed Argentine writers such as Florencia Bonelli and Mirta Pérez Rey will be there for you to meet your favorite female storytellers. There will be talks, classes, games, and other girl power stuff. Spice up your life. You will also need to sign up before going, so check it out on social media. Also, I wonder how long until someone in the comments below claims that the bubble has been officially taken over by the feminazis. Whatever, Raul. If you don't like it, you can watch Bailando por un Sueño. It's back next week, and I know you cannot wait. And if you're looking for something to do tonight, fret not, because I have the perfect plan for you. Actually, I will be there myself, so check it out. If you like great music that reminds you of the 80s, aka my glory days, and singers that don't need auto-tune, then head over to Club Cultural Matienzo to listen to the amazingly hot Lucas in the Woods. It's 150 pesos and totally worth it. They're such babes. Like, do you think they'll date me? Okay, guys, we made it. Once again, we survived. You stuck with me to the end. You are rock stars. We'll be back for more next week. In the meantime, call me. OMG. thank you so much for all the messages of support from last week. They really mean a lot to me. Except for those of you who told me to go fuck myself. Those weren't really that great, I'm not gonna lie. But at least there was some initiative, so, I mean, I'll give you points for that. But I don't really know.